Hi friends, welcome to our channel Be Smarter. Hope you are familiar with our introduction concepts of abacus and beads value. Let's have the recap of it. As this is abacus, frame of abacus and status bar, the center dot, its unit rod, below the bar, these are lower beads, above the bar, upper bead. Let's have the recap on beads value. Now there is no bead touching the bar, so it's 0. 1, only 1 bead is touching. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the value is 4. When we want 3, 1, 2, 3. So now let's have 2. So lower bead values we have done. Now with the upper bead, only 1 upper bead is 5. Now 5 plus 1, 6. So let's have together 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then 5, 6, 7, 8. Now let's have the last number 5, 6, 7. Hope you all remember the beads value. So now let's get started with the sum. So when we are going to start the sum, here you can see it's going to be with the addition and subtraction for the first level. So when we are having this, here the first sum starts with 1. So what we are going to do is look below. There are 4 beads. So with this 4 beads, can we able to add 1? Use your thumb to push up. So just we are going to use our thumb finger to add 1 for the lower bead. So we have got 1. The next number is 2. So look below. We have 3 beads. From 3, can we push up to? Yes. So use your thumb to push up. We are having 3 now. So got 3. Next 1. Look below. There is 1 bead. Can we push up? Yes. Use your thumb to push up. So we are having 4 beads now. Next, is there any other number to be added? No. So next nothing. We have to set the beads before writing the answer. So we have got the answer as 4. This is the way we have to start the sum. So let me tell you, whenever we start, how can we use this right fingers, thumb and forefinger? What we can do is, when you are going to write, take a pencil, just you can shoot like this, like a gun. Hold your pencil here between your ring finger and middle finger and you can fold it. So here easily you can use your thumb and forefinger. As I told you, for the lower beads, adding, we are going to use our thumb. Then when it comes for lesson, I'll explain how the way we are going to do with the forefinger. Now let's get started with the second sum. What's the number here? 2. So look below. There are 4 beads. Can you add 2? Obviously, yes. Use your thumb to push up. So we have got 2. Next 1. Look below. Can we able to push up 1? Yes, because we have 2. Use your thumb to push up. So now I have got 3. What is the next number? That is 1. So look below. Can you able to push up? Yes. Use your thumb to push up. So how much I have got? When we counting? 4. So next there is no number. So set 0. You can write the answer as 4. The same way, look at the sum. Look below. Use your thumb to push up. Now we have got 3. Next 1. Look below. Is it enough? Enough. Use your thumb to push up. We have got 4. Next, when we are having this subtraction, less. So we have to differentiate as it's less. So what we are going to do, we are going to cut. So here we have to make sure that it's not adding, it's reducing. So that look below, there are 4. From 4, can we cut 2? So we have to pull down. So here I am going to use my index finger, which we can see forefinger. Use forefinger to pull down. So here we are just lessing the number. How much I have got? 2. Set 0. Write the answer 2. So here we have less. So that is the reason we have used our forefinger to pull down. Look at the sum 4. Look below. Is it enough? Enough. Use your thumb to push up. So the thumb is powerful. We have to use the thumb to push up. So I have got 4. Next, less 2. So here I can differentiate it. Look below. Is it enough? 1, 2.
Can I cut too?
Yes. Use your forefinger to pull down. So here I have used my forefinger. Pull down. Got two. Next one. Look below. Is it enough? Yes. Use your thumb to push up. So I have got three. There is no more number. So I can set zero. Answer is three. Always before writing the answer, we have to keep the abacus in zero's place. So that is what set zero. Now let's start. Look at the sum. One. Look below. Enough. Use your thumb to push up. So got one. Next to two. Look below. We have three. Can I able to push up two? Yes. Use your thumb to push up. Next, less three. Look below. From three. Can we pull down three? Yes. Use your forefinger to pull down. So how much I am having? Zero. So there is no need to set zero. Answer is zero. In this way, we can learn addition and subtraction with the lower bit. So once I am repeating, for addition, we are going to use the thumb. We have to push up with thumb. For subtraction, we are going to use the index finger, which can be said as even forefinger. It's not four fingers, it's forefinger. What's the difference? It can be said as homophone. Learning is fun, right? F-O-U-R and F-O-R-E. This is the number four. And this is like forehead. We say the front. So, forefinger. Here you have learned one new thing. It's a homophone, which is like similar sound. But the spelling and the meaning is different. That is what homophone. The same way, you can find out some more, which can be interesting. As whenever we learn, parallelly we can learn which are related to them, so that we can able to learn n number of things with excitement and enthusiasm. Hope you all clear with addition with the thumb, forefinger for subtraction. So now let me show you, as this is my abacus, I have done it this way. So if you are going to do with your abacus, how can you able to do it? As it's a small abacus, if you are having the abacus with you, well and good. In case, I don't have abacus with me, as it's lockdown, we can't go for shopping, so what will I do? Don't worry. What we can do is, as it's first level, we will be using only two rods. So that the most important rod is units rod, which can be defined likewise. So what we can do? We can take any frame which is available at home itself. It can be old photo frame, or else even it can be like any wooden frame. Even it can be like the waste material, like what we are having with the string. So whatever it's available with you, you can take it, and you can take a string and you can just tie into two rods, which is going to be the units rod here and next to units rod, because upcoming pages, when we will be reaching for double digit, obviously we will be using this rod also, as this is the tens rod. Gradually I'll introduce to you. So what we are going to do here, you can just take a string with four beads below, one bead above. In the same manner, you can just like have four beads below and one bead above. So in this way, when you have like homemade with the two strings, whatever the beads available with you, you can make it. Even like if you have any part which you can move manually, that is fine. So you can make this abacus at home itself with the two rods, so that you can use the abacus the same manner. Plus, whoever it's not having the textbook, no need to worry. Whenever I'm giving here, you can take any notebook which you can follow for only abacus. So you can copy down the sums and you can practice with your own abacus. So in this way you can learn. Hope it's clear. Now let's get started with the next activity. As we have given in the last class, do you remember the prime teaser? What ends in W but has no end. Even I have given extra clues also for that. Whoever found the answer, well and good. The answer for that, the two clues are there already with the question. What ends in W but has no end. So the word is ending with W, but for the thing there is no end from the question. Then the clues which are I have given, it's a natural thing, you can't touch. The word is having 7 letters. So the answer for that is rainbow. If you have found, very good, excellent. So likewise, let's get started with the next activity. Tongue twister. Tongue twisters are like very familiar to us. Even almost all the languages are having tongue twister. It can be our mother tongue, or else even English, there are tongue twisters. If you see the tongue twister, it's nothing but it's a group of words. Either it gives meaning or it doesn't. But the words are like repeatedly arranged as like where we can confuse or where we can twist our tongue actually. For example, it can be nine, night, nurses, nursing nicely. So if I write, let me write this. According to the age, we can introduce with the group of words. For smaller kids, it can be two words. For example, red bulb, blue bulb. So for 5 years, let them practice only red bulb, blue bulb, red bulb, blue bulb. So here they have to practice. When they say faster, then it will be humorous too. If they are like quite elder, then they can have nine, night, nurses, nursing nicely. So in this way, all the words started here with N. So when we say nine, night, nurses, nursing nicely, nine, night, nurses, nursing nicely, nine, night, nurses, nursing nicely. So when we say faster, really it will be fun. Likewise, you all can have the tongue twisters for fun. And secondly, like it's to improve our fluency. Whenever like we speak, it will help to improve our pronunciation, to pronounce the words better. So what we can do is we can list out. Even we can ask our near and dears for the tongue twisters in our own mother tongue too. I hope you all enjoyed. So now let's wind up the class. We will meet you in the next session. Hope you all enjoy the class today. We are super excited to meet you in the next session. Thank you so much for watching. If you like our session, kindly give a thumbs up. If it's useful, please share it with your friends. If you haven't subscribed our channel, kindly subscribe and ring the bell icon. Till then, stay tuned with Be Smarter, Stay Stronger. Bye bye.